All right, everyone. Unfortunately, North Korea right now apparently is suffering from a form of famine. Some of their crops have failed, which might be why China said, I think last week, oh yeah, we're willing to meet with Kim Jong-un unconditionally. Like basically, yeah, come to China, come to Beijing, talk to Xi, and we'll have a good time. There's probably a strategic reason for that. Now, unfortunately, it looks like Korean relations slid back a half step. North Korea may have fired something off into the ocean. They thought it might be a missile test. No confirmation, I think, yet on whether that's the case. The hope is that it wasn't a missile, or it's one of their older ones, and they're like, they come out with their state press, say, oh no, we fired it off just because it was like old and unusable, and it's like, you know, screw it or something. We decided to disarm. We're just going to fire all of our nukes into the ocean or something like that. That'd be a funny idea. Like, we want to spawn Godzilla because we want to be peaceful, but we want Japan out of the way first, so we're going to be the worst nightmare. It's going to be radioactivity time. This is obviously not a good thing. Anytime you've got, like, people starving and shit. And North Korea, a lot of people are malnourished there anyway. So if they're gripped by a famine and China doesn't step in and send them free food or something, it's always a problem. I think Trump should offer aid and relief. I think that the West should preempt the Chinese and do that. Say, look, you know, we can be your guarantor. We got more money in rice at this point anyway, so no worries. China has more and more difficulties because they poisoned, what, 20% of their arable land beyond their ability. Now they've got an initiative to plant, what was it, like 10 billion trees or something along those lines to replace all the dead forests that they cut down for their industry over the last century. It's actually a surreal sort of situation. So it's not a good thing, but it may put pressure. I hate to put a positive spin on a famine of all things, but it may actually affect the geostrategic sort of situation there in favor of U.S. negotiation. Even if China steps in, it puts stress on the North Korean leadership. They may feel like, hey, we need more optic wins, more diplomatic wins, and the way to do that is to maybe have another era of good feeling sort of situation with South Korea and with the United States. That could happen, especially if it's prolonged, but it could take years for that to actually occur. The thing is, North Korea happens to be in a special location in the world that is repeatedly racked by droughts and floods, which means that their arable land, which they've got one swath of the country, much of it is very mountainous, and it's not really, you can't plant much there. Rocky soil, limited water availability. There are water shortages in North Korea, actually, believe it or not. But their sort of lower-lying, more arable area, it happens to be in a location that weather patterns can be kind of erratic in, and so it can become a problem. So what may end up happening is North Korea may end up having no choice but to go back to negotiating in order to get sanction relief, which would be a good thing. Kim Jong-un should just come out, look, if he's looking for an excuse to, like, end the Korean conflict sort of bullshit anyway, he should come out and say, well, it's clear that, you know, my ancestral spirits have spoken, they will that Korea should be, you know, united in the future, I am going to be the great leader who takes that step. Eh, he could do that. I mean, he is the dictator of the country. The only problem is the Chinese might lean on him not to do that. Oh, no, we'll give you food, just don't talk to Trump again. Because we're afraid you might strike an actual deal. Now, Trump came out, actually, I think it was yesterday, literally, and said, well, I know that my good friend Kim Jong-un doesn't want to disappoint his people, and he'll do the right thing. There will be a deal, trust me. He seems optimistic. It could just be a little bit of bluster on his part, but it also could be a diplomatic trick. See, again, in Korean politics, the idea of honor matters. I know it's not like in Western politics where people stab each other in the back while drinking wine together and crazy shit like that. It's more like it's a floor show of honor and respectability. To dishonor someone is traditionally frowned upon. And so Trump is putting the onus on him to come back to the table during a famine while the Chinese are also trying to meet with him. I think Kim Jong-un just talked to Putin a little while ago. I think that that's a good idea too, because even if Russia has less at stake there, Putin, the Russians are more of a neutral party, which sounds hilarious, but it really is. China has been the one propping up North Korea. Russia diplomatically washed their hands of the situation generally some time ago and is neither a supporter nor an enemy of the state. We've been more on the hostile side, China's been more on the allied side. All of these things are beginning to shift. That is, we're less hostile, they're less hostile towards us, China's less friendly, and the North Korean leadership less friendly towards them. And Russia really has nothing to gain beyond the smuggling opportunities with North Korea's sanctions. So Putin is more of the intermediary, I think, trying to broker something that's acceptable to all of the major powers in the world. of course, we're representing the NATO sphere. Russia and China sort of represent the East, but Russia's stepped up to be the mediator in the negotiations, which is pretty funny. My hope is still that North Korea will eventually achieve full peace with the ROK, with South Korea, that that'll occur. And if that manages to happen, of course, I think it's better for the entire world. I think that there's one less nuclear flashpoint in the world that could end the world. Because even if a local exchange of atomic hellfire wouldn't end the world, like if the entire Korea Peninsula gets obliterated tomorrow in a nuclear exchange, the world doesn't end. But if it involves China, and it inevitably involves us unleashing nukes too, yes, it could potentially end mankind as we know it for a very long time. It would be a bit of a fallout scenario, and I just think that that would be rather sad. Because most of the people dying wouldn't be combatants, they'd just be people that wanted to farm rice, and that wouldn't be nice. That's about all. Peace out.